Here we are again, it's Dan here. We're back down in the basement of this superb guitar interactive magazine. We are looking at this big articulate sounding MTD Kz5 bass in this review from Michael Tobias Design. This instrument, 35 inch scale, 24 fret neck. Let's get up to the headstock end of things, have a quick look around the front. Round the back, should I say, and we'll get into the details down at the control section of the instrument. Okay, so five nice lightweight tuning keys. Okay, flip the bass over, have a look on the back of the neck. Here we go. There we go. Maple neck, looks like. Angled back headstock as well. There we go, around we go. And then coming over, zero fret. I'll put some details in the write-up. This features the Buzz Phaeton tuning system. I'll go into that, but let's just say that it helps with the tuning down the low frets on the neck. But moving on, we have got rosewood fingerboard. And as I said, these frets are absolutely spot on, no sharp edges. Nice and clean, and there's no markers on the front as well, so it looks like there's about a million frets on the front of this neck, so it's going to look great from an audience point of view. But across the top of the neck, let me just roll it forward for you, we've got some nice little dot markers so you can see where you are, like so. Okay, rolling back. The maple neck is bolted onto a carved mahogany body. And we've got a very, very nice maple burl top with this lovely burst finish on it as well. I do like mahogany. I've always been a fan of mahogany in bodies. And it's got a lovely, nice character, the tone. Nice and woody, you can see that. Okay, and then right on to our pickup selection here. We've got a pair of MTD passive pickups, but hopefully you can see the detail on this if you kind of like, you know, looking a bit closer. The pickups have got these lovely wood covers to them. So rather than being kind of just a normal black boxes on the body, I think that's really nice. I'd like to see that on more bases, actually, in keeping with the colour scheme. Rather than, as I say, just black soap bars, which, I don't know, maybe we're so used to seeing them, but I think in some ways it detracts from the look of the instrument. Coming around to the back, we have... this is not like one of those really high mass bridges. We've got a nice kind of curved shape to the bridge here, but it's still one of those quick release ones. So you can pop your string straight in the back, straight down to the headstock, tune it up nice and quickly. That's going to save lots of time on string changes, which all of us bass players really love. So we do like to be able to change strings quickly, that's for sure. Okay, coming around to the controls here, we have, now this I found a little bit confusing, I have to admit. I'm so used to having the master volume control, almost like top central near the pickups. You'll be mistaken, unfortunately. This is the master volume here. We have a pan control here between the two pickups, front and back. And then we have a three-band EQ, treble, middle, and bass. And that's cut and boost at center frequencies. We'll have a little listen to those whilst we're at it. Okay, so front pickup, this lovely wooden-covered soap bar here. And what I've done is I've set the EQ, just double-check that. Yeah, it's all nice and flat. We'll listen to the front pickup. Both together, and then the back pickup again. We can listen to them as a combination, and then I'll just throw some EQ on there as well so you can hear what this bass is capable of. Some really nice tones. Okay, so a bit of finger style on that front pickup. Here we go. Nice, lovely open sound, nice and musical. Let's go around to the back pickup, and I'll do something similar. Here we go. Nice biting sound there. I kind of really want to reach for the bass control and just throw some extra low on there. Let's just see what happens when I do that. Yeah, good. I'm glad I did that, actually. I think the back pickup on its own, I liked that bite, and it certainly had a lot of upper mid-range punch when I dug in, the volume leapt up. But I found when I added a bit of slap bass in there, I wanted a bit more of a throb from it. So reaching for the bass control, that evened it out nicely. So the combination of the two is really the way to go, I think, on that particular setting, for me anyway. Okay, so right back in the middle again, I'm going to just quickly sweep through the EQ and we'll have a little listen to how much control we've got. You heard the bass boost on that rear pickup and even that had enough to kick through. So we're going to notice quite a big difference. Okay, so we'll go from the other end. We'll start with the treble first. So boost and cut, we're on zero at the moment. Here we go. And then I'll cut it all away. Very much a little bit of a noodle there, just to work around on that control. So I boosted the treble a little bit, boosted it a little bit more, and then cut it away right down to its lowest setting. There seemed to be, it adds a bit of fret noise to the high setting, but it's definitely a nice ping to the notes as well. And then coming back the other way, a rounding off of the top end. So if you want more of a finger style sound from using a plectrum, then actually that would be a good setting to have by being able to roll off that amount of top end. Okay, so back to the zero position. We've got middle control. Let's go for some boost. Here we go. Oh no, sorry. Zero setting first. Here we go. And then cutting it away. I like that. There's a boost to the upper mid-range. I'm not quite sure what the center frequency is for this. If I can find out, I shall put it in the written review for you as well. But it's a bit on the high side for me. I would prefer something a bit in the lower mid-range, which still adds a bit of weight to the instrument. However, it brought out some extra clarity in the instrument, which would be very, very useful for soloing, or maybe if you're using some distortion and want a bit of extra articulation, then actually that would probably help in there without making things too muddy. Speaking of muddy, let's go right down to the low end. So we've got the bass control here, boost and cut. So start at zero again. Here we go. And then cutting away. Tons of boost, but tons of cut as well. I didn't even max out that bass control, and I had to watch it a little bit because I could tell that this was peaking on the studio amp a little bit. However, cutting away, I lost a bit of weight on this. So again, with any EQ, always be aware of how much you're boosting or cutting. Sometimes you could like trim away just a bit too much, or of course upset your engineer and boost too much as well. So there's a lot of boost and cut available on this particular EQ. But you can hear that when you hit that little magic spot, it sounds really, really cool. I'm gonna just do one more thing. I wanna boost a bit of bass, bit of treble, and then I'm gonna cut out a little bit of the mids. So this is your typical, what they call a smiley face EQ on an amplifier, where you have that graphic equalizer doing like a little smiley mouth. So boost, treble and bass, cut a little bit of mids out, and then my favorite setting so far has been the two pickups just on together. So let's have one last listen, and we'll round up the review. That's it, fantastic. That's the little magic spot for that EQ, I'm sure. So this was the MTD Kz5. Absolutely fantastic bass. Nice and light, nice and well balanced. And certainly for the price conscious amongst us, then I think this is gonna be a good one to budget and factor in when you go out and try a new five string. So, more information coming up in the written part of the magazine, and I will of course catch up with you again very soon. This has been Dan in Guitar Interactive magazine. Thanks ever so much for watching.